Indianapolis, a little place in the middle of the U.S., right? Indiana people tend to speak in very lovingly ways about their home. So, there must be something about it. Yeah. They seem to love motor racing. Ha! Huh. I guess you already know that sisters, Lily and Madeline, are from Indianapolis as well. Yeah, they are. Here you can see them when they were still small. Dancing and singing from day one, amazing. And very promising, as you will get to see. These names, Lily and Madeline. So catchy. Perfect name for a folk or pop band, right? Lily and Madeline. Sounds like somewhere someone has a huge talent. And they have. I mean, for real. Most likely more than you could imagine. Ah, I love some time traveling. Now it's 2012. Lily and Madeline, been singing all the while. But, nowhere professional. It's not intended to be, just for fun. They love Swedish music act, First Aid Kit, and, so they record, a cover version of them, just for fun, and upload it to YouTube. In November 2012, Lily and Madeline appear on YouTube again. This time by their names, and, most importantly, with an original song called In the Middle, referring to Indianapolis, causing a buzz on the internet, making their names well known.
The river is white, it's tangled and dry. I still remember you here, swimming in the middle.
But what had happened in between?
Have you always been, you know, singing together, playing together? Like, how's it come about?
Well, our mom is musical, and so she plays piano and guitar, and she sings. She's always singing around the house, and she started us with piano lessons when we were about 8, I want to say. So we've always had music in our lives, and we've always sang together, but we just started singing professionally about 2 years ago when somebody in southern Indiana, where we live, kind of discovered us because we posted like a cover online and wanted to have us write our own songs and then record things, and it just took off,
yeah,
like we never expected.
What days have come to keep us far apart? A broken promise.
In June 2012, Lily, Madeline, and their mother Mary record an audition at Paul Mahern's White Ox Studio, resulting in Lily and Madeline having a manager, producer, and the task to write a song each day for the run of 2 weeks. Oh my god.
We were challenged to write a song a day for 2 weeks by Paul, which I thought was ridiculous, but it ended up being good. The first things we wrote about were probably just feeling weird at home. Like, our friends were really good at sports and we like weren't good at anything. And
yeah, just like normal teenage feelings.
And we wrote about, like, you know, feeling like maybe we could do something musical, you know, like in the future, just like looking ahead. But yeah, it was a lot of themes of like insecurity or like change that we weren't sure about.
Don't worry, girls. You are up to it, believe me. And you got the man, Kenny Shielders, of Bloomington band, Gentleman Caller, at your side.
I go. long gone. I can't get up. I can't get up.
The Weight of the Globe, formerly called The Weight of Our Globe, is released on June 11, 2013, by Asthmatic Kitty Records, to warm critical acclaim.
The river is white, it's tangled and dry, but I still remember you here.
A lot of people say that the EP was kind of sad. And I suppose that that's true, that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's kind of moody, I guess.
I think when we wrote and did the EP, we kind of thought of it more as like a project. Mm-hmm. Like it could go to a career, or it could just be like, I don't know, like a little yeah. project, like a music project, just to try it. But then once it came out and it got such great response, I think we were like, let's yeah. go for another.
To support the album, the girls do some in-studio acoustic versions of selected album tracks. One of them, Come To Me, is the second single from the album. Here they are, on Second Cup Coffee, a CBS morning show, to perform Come To Me.
Pure is a word rarely used when describing contemporary popular music, but it's exactly right for the two voices you are about to hear. Sisters Lily and Madeleine gained notice last year when the video of their song In the Middle went viral. Now the Indianapolis-born teenagers have recorded their first full-length album.
Titled Lily and Madeleine, it will be released on October 29th. And now making their national television debut here in our Second Cup Cafe, Lily and Madeleine.
The sky was falling over us. If the ground below was turned to dust, would you come to me? Would you come to me? Would you come?
In early 2014, Lily and Madeleine are on their first UK tour and already having album number 2 on their minds.
Because you're sisters, aren't you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So how did you go from just sisters singing together to then label interest? You know, you put out the album, haven't you, on Sufjan Stevens' label,
yeah.
Asthmatic Kitty, and then Secretly Canadian over in the UK. Is that who you're on tour with? So how did it all go from just singing together and making some tunes to then that?
Well, it happened really fast. Yeah. About a year ago was our first ever public show, and so we never thought that 12 months later we'd be in London doing a session, like, no big deal. But I don't know, I guess it's just been connections mm-hmm. and, like...
People
who believe in us.
Just we like have neighbors, some, friends.
Yeah, amazing supports around us, I guess.
Yeah.
And our parents are really supportive, which is nice.
Yeah.
Supportive enough to let us come out of school to travel and tour for a bit this semester, which is really, really nice. I don't know, it's just happened really fast, and it's also been a little bit confusing. It hasn't been very rocky, it's mostly just been kind of like uphill, but the emotions are just kind of like, is this what we should be doing right now? Should we really come out of school for this? Is it worth it? But because we have this opportunity, and I think we'll probably never get an opportunity like this again, we took it, and I'm glad we did.
Yeah, because you got into the industry relative, I mean, maybe not Bieber young, but quite young.
Yeah.
You're 19
mm-hmm.
and you're 16?
17. Just turned 17.
Okay, but when, you know, so a year ago you were a bit younger.
Yeah.
And how is it being sisters in a band? Do you get on? Do you tell each other everything? Or?
Yeah, it was hard at first. Like when we first started writing music, we didn't really know how, and it was just kind of like, you know, confusing and overwhelming. But now it's really fun, and it's really nice to have my sister there because, like, you know, we know each other as well as you can know a person, and there's nothing, like, awkward to get over of, like, sharing a hotel room every single night. So, yeah,
it's good.
But you said you're already making the second album, so...
Yeah, we've been working hard. It's coming great, yeah. We've been writing throughout the winter, and we're going to get into the studio in March. Start recording, I guess, before the single even comes out. But that was for the last album.
Yeah.
So I guess we have been moving pretty fast. But like, why stop?
This is a new song. It's called Fumes. Thank you.
Finally, back at home, Lily and Madeleine are talking about the new album, the approach of recording, and the shooting of the cover photo.
Local singer-songwriters Lily and Madeleine. And if you are familiar with them, you should be. They're incredible talents. We're pleased to have you back here on Indie Style. You guys are getting ready to debut a brand new album.
Yep.
You mentioned maybe the creative process isn't that different album to album, but maybe the flavors and flair kind of is.
Yeah, exactly. The process really wasn't different for this album, mm-hmm. But the product, I think, is pretty different than our first stuff. We wrote everything together, but then once we got into the studio, we
had much more time to record.
Mm-hmm. So. And we brought in some new musicians.
Too, right?
Yeah.
Be able to sort of work with new musicians and mm-hmm. feel like you can take your time and craft
yeah.
it like the way you want it to turn out.
Yeah,
now,
it's really nice.
And I think we have a album shot right here of the cover. The photo is just absolutely beautiful. Talk to me about the inspiration behind that and sort of how that complements the actual music inside.
Well, first of all, thank you so much. We're really pleased with the way it turned out, too. It was kind of a last-minute thing.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't sure what we wanted the cover to look like, but then we had a suggestion from a friend to do a shot like that in a boat on the water, and immediately we thought of the Tennyson poem, Lady of Shalott,
mm-hmm.
And we love the reference to it in that movie, Anne of Green Gables, and we thought it was a really neat idea, and we liked the themes of the poem and the way that it would work with the music. So we were on Lake Monroe one day and just got some shots, and it started raining in the middle,
yeah,
and we got soaked, so we had to like start over. It was quite a process, but it turned out.
Well, when we produced it, it became like a pop song, like the most pop song we've ever made. But
mm-hmm.
When we wrote it, it was a lot more stripped down. It was on the piano originally. And I don't know, whenever we sing it, I still like feel the emotion
mm-hmm.
and the simplicity of it. So I like performing it a lot.
All right, well, go right ahead and play for us here,
okay.
ladies.
Right. This is our single, Rabbit.
Leave mine a mystery. This slope is slippery. Oh my God. Rabbit, run for it, as if your life depends on it. Take all your promises, 'cause you're all talk. Somehow, I'm running out. We stop and start. I swear, you know just how to break this heart. My coat, I'm staying down the hole. Oh, rabbit, go, just disappear. Somehow, I'm running out. We stop and start. I swear, you know just how to break this heart. Somehow, I'm running out. We stop and start. I swear, you know just how to break this heart.
Lovely, lovely. And your words are still just so raw and so real. And I think that's what people like and appreciate the most about your music.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.